Hi! Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Welcome again to my channel. My name is Dove and this is ECQ Daily. So, this is our second Sunday of quarantine, right? We're almost over week 2. And so far, so good. We're okay naman, di ba? Masaya naman tayo, ligtas tayo. But still, hindi natin maaalis yung worries and fears natin. Kasi nako, mahigit 1,000 na po yung ating cases ng confirmed COVID people. So, walang pinipili po talaga ang virus. Mayaman, mahirap, artista man, celebrity man, or simpleng tao, pwede at pwede siyang kapitan ng coronavirus. And the good thing is that tayo, sa kabila ng mga ganitong sitwasyon, tayong mga Pilipino, hindi pa rin talaga tayo totally nasisiraan ng ulo sa mga nangyayari at masyadong nagpapanik. Because I noticed, karamihan din naman sa ating mga Pilipino ay sumusunod sa kung anong sinasabi ng government. So, i-share ko lang for this morning. This is Sunday. Later, I'll be watching an online streaming ng Sunday service. And I just woke up and prepared my breakfast a while ago, and I have coffee. So ayun, yung burger ko ay nag-fail dahil nasunog yung patty. So parang naging corn burger na siya, hindi na siya burger patty na durog. So ayun, yesterday we had a Zoom meeting with my D group ladies, discipleship group ladies in CCF. And napag-usapan namin kahapon yung ano yung tatlong realization namin for this COVID-19 quarantine. Na-share ko na yan sa unang-una kong vlog, my realizations after a week of quarantine. Kahapon we shared and most of us realized that the quarantine is really an opportunity for us to enjoy quality family time. Because on a normal days, nagiging busy tayo, ang daming demands ng mga work natin, ng mga businesses natin, kinakain tayo ng sistema, but then we were being stopped from that on-the-go life that we have, lives that we have, and made us stay home. And staying home, it gives us more time to be with our families, to be with our children, if we're parents, to be with our spouses, if we're married, to be with our with our immediate family, kung single ka, you're with your parents, with your siblings, ganon. And for those na na-quarantine and didn't make it home in the province sa mga pamilya nila, that person has the chance to check on his or her spiritual life and really think about God. Sa panahon ngayon, wala tayong ibang masyadong iniisip kundi ang Panginoon na tulungan niya tayo na matapos ng lahat ng to, matapos na itong outbreak na to, matapos na tong itong virus na to, kasi it's increasing talaga. And marami sa atin din nagwo-worry na baka ma-extend yung lockdown. My gosh, kung ma-extend hanggang kailan naman. Pero as of now, wala pang advice ang Pangulo. So wag muna tayong magpanic because the government is still studying, strategizing what to do with the increasing number of confirmed cases. So for us, it's just, stay at home and obey. I noticed yesterday when we went to the supermarket, lahat naka-mask na. Kasi okay na rin yun na lahat naka-mask, yung iba naka-gloves. Because hindi na natin kasi alam kung sino yung carrier or not. As ourselves, we can be carrier but still we don't have symptoms. So iwasan natin yung makahawa or mahawa. That's one of the realization for me, yung quality family bonding. Pangalawa is yung quality time with God, seeking His will, really taking time to see yourself and evaluate yourself what really matters most in your life. And what are the better plans that you can do na pag natapos itong COVID outbreak, you can do that valuable plan. And another thing is, this is really an opportunity. a time, a precious time for us believers, for those who receive Christ as their Lord and Savior, who receive the gift of salvation and have experienced the amazing love of God. This is the time for us to share the word, to share Jesus to other people, to share the gospel to other people by reaching out to them, caring for them, asking how they are, asking if they could have something that you can pray for. This is the time that you can tell the people to put their hope in Christ and not on any other things, but in Jesus alone, because the Bible said, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, and those who ever believe in Him will not perish but have everlasting life. So, kung yung assurance natin of what will happen kung mawawala na ako sa mundo na to, where will I go? So, if you want to have that eternal life with God, Jesus is the only way, the truth, and the life. So, this is our time to direct people's search for something or someone to hold on to, direct them to God, bring them closer to Jesus. Marami ding nagsisilabas ang mga iba't ibang articles about kung sino talaga daw ang totoong may pakana ng virus, kung ano daw talaga ang totoong ibig sabihin nito, bakit nagkaroon ng ganitong pandemic. Nire-relate nila to sa mga signs of the end times or sa mga napipintong World War III. Well, we'll never know because there are people really who dig deeper into this matter, and yung iba talagang they study hard. They've done the research, but we don't need to worry or stress ourselves out listening to this to these people or taking this news and predictions seriously, because it will add up to our stress. What we can do is to just wait, and stay at home and be safe. Yun lang, simple lang muna yung gawin natin. Huwag muna tayong mag-problema kasi wala pa naman tayo doon. Sabi nga, let's cross the bridge when we get there. Ang importante talaga this time is really we hold on to God for daily strength, for daily sustenance, yung providence ni God, yung protection for us and for our family. So, yun, those are one of my realizations for this enhanced community quarantine. That's why I prayed to the Lord na i-guide niya rin ako, na-inspire niya ako na every now and then, kung hindi man araw-araw, I could share something to you, something that is about your the growth of your spiritual life and getting to know Jesus, something about His words that you can hold on to. Kasi yung word ng Panginoon, the word of God is our light and to our path and a guide to our and a lamp to our feet. So yon sabi ko nga sana makapag-organize din ako ng cyber Bible study or online Bible study of with people within my media circle of influence. So, iniisip ko pa kung paano, pinagpipray ko pa rin kung paano ako ligatin. So, yun lang for my Sunday morning. Yun muna yung mishishare ko because I haven't done much yet at the start of the day. So, I'm not sure if I can go back with you later, guys. But for now, I wanted to thank the Lord for another week na okay ako, okay yung family ko, okay tayong lahat. And napakabuti ng Panginoon kasi yung provision niya andon. Kung tutusin, naging lesser din actually yung gastos ko. Kasi walang pasok, so hindi kailangang bumili ng extra or gumastos ng extra like pamasahe or extra food. Ang pagkakagastos naman lang talaga is your daily meals, yung kakainin mo. And I thank God for the food for the in the table that He provides for all of us. So let's pray. Father, we thank you for today. We glorify you and honor you for who you are in our lives and for what you have done in our lives, Lord. Thank you for the successful week number 2 of the enhanced community quarantine, that we are all better and safe, as well as our family and loved ones. Thank you, Jesus, for taking care of us. Thank you for calming our hearts, removing the fears, the worries, and anxieties. And thank you as well for provisions and sustenance and protection. We owe it all to you, God. We ask for forgiveness for all the sins that we have done. Forgive us, Lord, and cleanse us from all our unrighteousness. Help us to obey you with all our hearts. Help us to fear your name. Help us to love you with all of our might. We also lift to you, Lord God, our government, our president, the government officials, the frontliners, that you will take care of them, keep them safe, protect them from the virus, and give them wisdom on how to handle this challenge of the outbreak has cost our country. Provide for their needs as well. And for those confirmed cases, we pray na hindi na po ito madagdagan, Panginoon, because wala na yung virus. The virus is already dead and it's not being transmitted from one host to another. Yes, Lord, we believe that you will put an end to this virus, Panginoon. To those who got positive and infected, let them recover from this, Lord God. With your healing power, let them feel that you are the great healer and there's no diseases that you cannot heal. Even death, Lord, you have conquered it. Thank you because you are powerful and nothing is impossible with you. We lift you up, our hearts, our minds, that we will always have our focus in you, and that as the day goes by, we will come to know you more and we will come to experience your great love and your intervention, divine intervention in our lives. We thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. There you are. If you join me with a prayer, thank you. The Lord God will bless you. And let me know. Comment below your routines for the day and for the next week to come. And if you want me to pray for you, you can send me your prayer request through my Facebook Messenger, or inbox me, PM me, and suggestions and suggestions on topics that you may want me to share with you. I believe if I was able to experience it, kung makaka-relate man ako, then I can deliver it to you and share it with you by God's grace. So I wish you a wonderful week ahead, mga kaibigan. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.